watch Daughter Sky 7:30. Shilpa Shetty is teaching yoga.
Yes.
Right? So that, you've got a book, and of course you've got a whole family to take care of, and that goes into TV commerce story, Cooking with Bestie. Tell us more. I mean, of course we want to hear about all of them, but tell us about Bestie. I'm very intrigued because you're marrying the mediums, you're doing it differently, you're doing the same thing very differently.
Thank you, I think that is a huge compliment. I know when people sit down to list the number of things I'm doing, it's kind of overwhelming even for me to hear all about it, because I don't know how I managed to do so many things. It was never contrived. Things just kept happening. It was the right time. So I decided to take it up and or maybe leverage my name to it. But I still very clearly maintain that I am a full-time mother, and all the rest that I do is all part-time. I think I'm fortunate to be able to delegate those jobs. I have a very expensive CEO at Bestie TV, my husband Raj Kundra, who I have to pay in kind because he's unaffordable otherwise. But yes, I just think businesses, like even my spas, we've started the franchise model in IOSIS. Is all over India. We've got two in Guwahati, two in Lucknow, Pune, Calcutta. I have four in Mumbai. But I have a great business partner, you know, Kiran, who helps me run it. The only job I can't delegate to other people is the job of a mother. So that I have to be there personally. Even today, from the time Pian's been born, I used to pick him and drop him to school. Now Raj has started dropping him to school because it's on his way. But I enjoy doing that. For me, all the rest is just incidental. And I feel very fortunate to have my hero who supports me and who has made me a shero. So I can't take complete credit.
Wow, that's quite humble of you. Going further into Bestie TV, I think our missions align because one thing we say is we want to put 10 lakh women into opportunities at the end of 3 years, and all those opportunities won't come from the nature of jobs as we know them. And of course, you've built a model which is absolutely aligned to what the thought that went behind building it, because building this model is hard. I mean, I run this, so I know.
So thought of Bestie TV actually was, it just happened. I really believe, you know, sometimes in life you're just put in a place because you have to, you know, maybe you have to play a catalyst in doing something bigger. So it happened via another home shopping channel where they approached me to leverage my name. As an artist, we get to do a lot of things, you know, we do ads, we leverage our names for different brands. It's another story. I've become a brand myself now. So I said, so Raj very intelligently said to me, you know, you do it for other people, why don't you do it for yourself? So we actually, he came up with the idea when they had proposed to me that I should be selling saris on their channel. I said, why don't we make it SSK saris? So in the normal course, they would sell around 1,000 saris in a matter of, you know, they have these 1 hour slots where they sell these saris, designer saris. So I said, okay, I'll call them SSK and I'll design a range of 3 saris and let's just test the waters. So we just did some 5,000 saris only for us, you know, 3,000 saris just to start it. And I shot for it and we went on the channel and they started it, they aired it, and they sold 5,500 saris in 20 minutes.
Wow.
Yeah, so that's when the thought came to Raj and me, where we were like, you know, this is amazing. And I have to again give credit to Raj, because just to be able to set up a business in 4 months, he set up Bestie TV in 4 months, which is breakneck speed. So, and he's not somebody who just somebody who's hands-on. I've seen him put in 80-20 hours work. He doesn't need to do it, but he's very diligent. So I trust his acumen. That's how Best Deal was set up. We understood that in a country like India, there's 75% of penetration when it comes to, you know, TV commerce in comparison to just 25% when it's e-commerce. And you would think it would be the other way around. So there are a lot of people like us who would go to maybe a website and order something because it's cumbersome nowadays to go into the traffic and go and get your child a Christmas present, for example. Here you go on, you know, the thing, Flipkart or whatever, ABC, conflict of interest. And you're like, okay, buy something for my son, let me buy something for my mother-in-law, let me buy something. You basically do everybody's Christmas present. But for, you know, there's such a dichotomy. There are more masses than classes. I don't want to believe that we are more the classes, okay? But there are the masses which makes up like 75% of our audiences and customer base. Those people can't even afford to, or maybe don't even have the understanding of these e-commerce sites. So somebody in Bilaspur wants to buy something for her son for his birthday. She's flipping channels after sending her child to school and packing food for her husband. She has nothing to do in the afternoon. She sees Best Deal TV. Okay. So yeah, and we at Best Deal TV have tried to carve a niche for ourselves in the market. We're trying to reach out to customers with quality-oriented products, you know, and with a good price point. So that's where we've tried to, you know, create a niche for ourselves in the home shopping business. So the idea was his. And then the whole idea of the direct selling agent, the DSA came up with purely the idea of people like me. If I had my way, I would be at home 24/7. Because I really think being a homemaker is the biggest job in the world. It's truly heroic. There are women out there who dedicate 24/7 of their lives to their family, and it's a thankless job. They are not getting paid for it, and they do it with a smile on their face. And for me, I salute those women. So if I had my way, see, because you know, for me, it's easy for me to say that. It's easy, I can afford to do that. But there are a lot of women out there who can't. If they had a choice, they would want to be there to pick up their son from school, make sure they're there in time, to cook food for their husband when he gets back from work, cater and pander to his demands, the in-laws' demands, and be deadbeat by the end of the night, and still wake up at 6:30 in the morning again to prepare his lunch for his dabba and drop the child to school, go and do all the errands. There are women like that who do this every day. So this is, you know, and what if she's sitting and watching television and she can actually earn a few extra bucks by just becoming a direct selling agent for the channel? There is no fulfillment, everything is done by us. She only has to go and sell the product. Maybe she's gone to the market and she said, "Arey, ye dekha, ye naya kuch nikla hai Best Deal TV pe, ye bahut achhe price pe mil raha hai. Ek 60-piece stainless steel ka set Diwali ke liye de sakte hai. Aap kisi ki shaadi pe ja rahe hai, you can gift it. So that's how one, you know, the word of mouth spread. So that was really the idea. I think it comes from a place that I came from. I am very middle class. I was born and bred in Chembur. Both my parents worked. My father missed. He would walk from a train station to his factory in Amarnath so that he could give us a holiday in Mathiran. So those values are very, very strongly ingrained in me. And I value those holidays. I value those times. You know, today Vyan goes to a toy shop, and every time he goes to a toy shop, he wants a toy. So I'm very clear with Raj that, you know, and even Raj comes from that learning. His father started off as a bus conductor in London. So we come from that school of thought, which is great, I mean, you know, but it's so expensive. What, you can do it, there's an easier way to do it. Eat what is local, eat local, because it doesn't take so much time. By the time it reaches you, I don't know how much stuff they put into it to preserve it. So you're basically going to die anyways. She wants me to leave now.
I'm going to come to yoga, which is my favorite part of the the whole story. Where did you get started? I mean, did you learn yoga?
No, I started doing yoga, I think 12 years ago. No, maybe, sorry, it was 15 years ago. And it started off to try to cure myself because I ended up with spondylosis. And I was in the gym and I was watching television and I was trying to do crunches and suddenly I put my head down and there went a click and I couldn't get up. They actually had to lift me up and take me out because I injured my C4, C5 in my spine. And that was that taught me a lesson never to do crunches and, you know, watch television was supposed to look up. So yoga basically came into my life to cure me and I fell in love with it. And it's the only workout regimen in the world that is the most holistic, that stretches you, tones you, actually calms you, and you can do it on your own without any weights. So again, it's inexpensive. So I did it only because I valued my health. And through that again, you know, see, when I got associated with yoga, even Baba Ramdev also wasn't on the scene. So, and then when Baba Ramdev got associated to it, with due respect to him, I think he really introduced yoga back again to India. So I just felt that, you know, this man was doing such a wonderful job. My parents were doing it, but no, my sister doesn't want to do it. Because it's not cool to do yoga, you know. Now it is. Now there are a lot of yoga studios and Pilates and whatever. But 15 years ago, it wasn't that cool. So then Raj, again, the hero in my life, he was like, Achha, you know,